It's case dismissed against Levi Chavez. The former APD officer acquitted this summer of first-degree murder is now free of the wrongful death lawsuit brought against him by his wife's estate. We broke the story today on KOAT.com. Action 7 News reporter Ana Velasquez shows us why Tara Chavez's family asked the judge to throw the case out.
A document ending a five-year-long battle in civil court between the estate of Tara Chavez and Tara's husband at the time of her 2007 death, Levi Chavez. The wrongful death lawsuit against the former Albuquerque police officer is now dismissed. The civil case was on hold during this summer's criminal trial. After the jury acquitted Chavez of first-degree murder, he had this to say.
I don't care. Bring the civil case on. I'm not guilty. I'm innocent. Bring it on.
Since then, Chavez himself has asked the judge to dismiss the civil case. In August, court documents say he believed the city should have never been released from the lawsuit, and if the case moved forward, the city should pay for his defense. That request was denied. Then, in Chavez's answer to the civil suit, he said he would be representing himself in the trial. He added he is financially destitute, and any money he would be ordered to pay the estate would prevent him from becoming financially able to support his children, the grandchildren of the Cordovas. They are Joseph and Teresa Cordova's only remaining link to Tara. In an exclusive interview with Action 7 News and our partners at the Journal, Joseph Cordova looked into our camera in July and spoke directly to them.
Andrea, Levi, if you ever want to come home for a visit.
And in thinking about the welfare of their grandchildren, the Cordovas will not dispute Chavez's claim under oath that he has no assets or savings. They told me Friday, to extract money from the Chavez household will be placing hardship on our grandchildren. They have been through enough. We love and miss them. Our hope is that one day they will find their way home. The Cordovas tell me they have not been allowed to see their grandchildren since Levi Chavez was indicted in 2011. Ana Velasquez, KOAT Action 7 News.
The city settled with the estate for $230,000. The family's attorney, Brad Hall, also says the estate has collected Tara Chavez's life insurance. The funds are now in a trust fund for the kids. Also, money raised on the website Justice for Tara will be donated to a shelter for domestic violence victims.